We're going to talk now about degenerative disc disease. It's not really a disease process, that's its name, but it really is a disorder, just like arthritis is a disorder. Well, we remember that the disc, again, is the jelly-filled donut. You have the jelly or the nucleus on the inside, which is under high pressure, and you have the annulus or the outer plies of the tire, there's about 60 of them, that hold the jelly in. Well, over time, you can get tears within the disc. These tears look like this. They're called annular tears because the rings of collagen are making up the annulus. These tears by themselves can be quite painful. Many times when somebody says, "My back went out," they have just torn a very small portion of the annulus, and they can be incapacitated for 4 or 5 days, even a couple of weeks. Other people that get tears in the disc don't necessarily even notice them. The answer to why some people are incapacitated and others aren't is a Nobel Prize winning answer. So these tears cause back pain. And if you notice, the jelly itself actually seeps into these tears. The other very interesting thing about the nucleus or the jelly is that it is toxic to nerves. Why God or Mother Nature designed this system is anybody's guess. But when you have tears in the back of the disc and this jelly will seep next to the pain nerves, it aggravates them and sets them off. That's typically what starts the degenerative cascade or what causes these discs to start to go bad. The discs can fail in a number of different ways. You can tear through and through the disc, and if you do that, you can have a disc herniation. And that's what this looks like. You can see the tear through and through the disc where the jelly squirting out and back. The reason why this is a problem is because what's sitting in back here is the nerve root. And you start to compress the nerve root, and that causes leg pain. And so a herniated disc, not always, but very many times, will cause leg pain. The disc can also degenerate in other ways. The disc back wall can become very, very loose, and you can get a disc bulge. Not the best term in the world for this, but essentially a failure of the back wall of the disc, which can create further back pain. And this disc can continue to become degenerative until it literally turns into an old piece of shoe leather and doesn't work well to take the shock or the stress when you jump up and down. People with this kind of disc have chronic back pain. They don't tend to like to do activities that load the spine. Tennis, running, even jumping, sitting in a car, and biking can be quite painful to these patients. Some of the ones with more problematic discs have problems even with vibration. So sitting in a car for a prolonged period of time or sitting on an airplane is quite painful.